Everyone, I'm very pleased to see you again in this video. Today, I will talk about the topic, the three core issues to ensure boiler emissions meet environmental standards. As you know, in the current context, boilers meeting environmental standards is mandatory for all production facilities operating within the territory of Vietnam. Boilers are essential equipment in many industries, from food processing and chemicals to textiles and many other fields. However, if not designed and operated correctly, boilers cannot meet environmental standards and may adversely affect human health. Let me reiterate, a well-designed boiler that is improperly operated may still fail to meet environmental standards. We will analyze the emission issues in industrial boilers that typically burn biomass, coal, oil, gas, etc., and have a capacity range below 50 tons of steam per hour using saturated steam. This content is shared based on the experience of DIVI Group and may not cover everything. Your feedback is a great motivation for us. Please subscribe and share to support the channel. Now, let's begin. There are three issues that need to be addressed for boiler emissions to meet environmental standards. CO gas in the emissions, also known as carbon monoxide, particulate matter dispersed into the environment. SOx gases. Let's delve into each issue. CO gas. CO gas forms due to the incomplete combustion of fuel in the combustion chamber. CO is an inert gas that is difficult to absorb, and we can only control CO through the combustion process in the combustion chamber. CO formation is influenced by the following four factors. Moisture content of the fuel. To ensure that boilers meet environmental standards, it is essential to use fuel that has not been exposed to water or rain. The lower the moisture content, the more efficient the combustion process, and the fuel will burn more completely, reducing CO formation. Thus, we should strive to minimize fuel moisture content for environmental protection. Fuel feed rate matching load. The fuel feed system and oxygen supply fan must be controlled linearly in response to boiler pressure signals. When boiler pressure rises, the fuel feed system and oxygen fan will reduce output. Conversely, when boiler pressure decreases, the system will increase the fuel and oxygen supply in the combustion chamber. This adjustment ensures that the fuel and oxygen are always supplied just enough to meet the plant steam demand, enabling continuous boiler operation and reducing CO formation in the emissions. Appropriate oxygen level relative to fuel feed. A general rule to note, both excess and insufficient oxygen during combustion can lead to CO formation. Excess oxygen often results in white, opaque smoke, while insufficient oxygen typically results in black smoke. Therefore, adjusting the oxygen level to match the fuel feed is essential to minimize CO formation. Oxygen level adjustment involves regulating the air supply fan into the combustion chamber and can be done in several ways. Method 1. Use measuring instruments or sensors to determine the oxygen and CO levels in the emissions, which helps set the optimal modes for the air supply fan and fuel feed system. Adjustments should be made whenever there is a change in fuel. Method 2. Rely on smoke color. This method only applies if the dust control system meets standards and the smoke color is due to CO. Black smoke indicates a lack of oxygen, requiring an increase in the air supply fan. White. Opaque smoke with excess smoke suggests an oxygen surplus, necessitating a decrease in the air supply fan. Combustion temperature of fuel. The combustion temperature at the core of the combustion chamber should be maintained above 800 degrees Celsius to eliminate CO formation and emissions. High moisture fuels, in particular, make it challenging to maintain this core temperature without a suitable combustion chamber design. This is why DIVI Group's boilers have a thick layer of bricks in the combustion area, creating a fuel kiln that intensifies combustion at the core above 800 degrees Celsius. Proper design ensures optimal combustion temperature. I have finished sharing the issue of CO gas. Now, let's move on to the next issue. 2. Dust recovery. An effective dust recovery system is essential to prevent dust dispersion into the environment. This system collects all the dust generated during fuel combustion. Without treatment, dust can pollute the air, harming the environment and human health. Currently, there are many types of dust recovery systems, and I'd like to share some popular types in the Vietnamese. Cyclone dust collection by centrifugal sedimentation. DIVI Group has shared knowledge on guidelines and calculations for cyclone dust collector design on our channel. Cyclone dust collectors are available in two types. Single cyclone with one dust collecting element. Multi-cyclone consisting of many small dust collecting elements. Multi-cyclones are much more efficient than single cyclones and are widely used in boiler dust collection, although their manufacturing cost is significantly higher than single-element cyclones. Cyclones are only effective for recovering dust particles larger than 10 microns. For finer particles, other types of dust recovery systems are required. Fabric bag dust system. This system has multiple filter bags through which the smoke passes, trapping dust particles while allowing only clean air through. For details on the operation of the fabric bag dust collection system, please see the video 3D simulation of biomass-fired fluidized bed boiler on our channel. This type of system has an almost absolute dust recovery rate, collecting only dry dust, and the emissions appear nearly colorless. However, it requires a large space, high investment, and high maintenance costs. Wet scrubber dust collection. This system uses water spray to capture dust particles in the smoke. While it has good dust collection efficiency and saves space, there are some drawbacks. High water consumption. Emissions appear white from water vapor, which may concern surrounding residents who do not understand the system. It collects wet dust, which is not as clean as the dry dust captured by fabric bag filters. Additionally, there is an electrostatic dust recovery system, which typically has a very high investment cost and is used in high-capacity boilers. It is not cost-effective for smaller industrial boilers, so I will not cover it in this video. In practice, combining these methods helps ensure that boiler dust emissions meet environmental standards, depending on each customer's specific conditions, such as space, finances, local environmental requirements, and production standards, different dust recovery systems may be combined. For example, for companies in cities, residential areas, or with high production standards, a combination of multi-cyclones and fabric bag filters is recommended. For companies in industrial zones, a combination of multi-cyclones and water-based dust recovery is recommended. That concludes the second issue regarding dust recovery. Now, let's move on to the final issue. 3. SOx gas treatment. The issue of SOx gases is often encountered in boilers that use fuels high in sulfur, such as FO, mazut oil, cashew shell oil, recycled rubber oil, coal, etc. SOx gases include two components, SO2 and SO3. SOx treatment is relatively simple by using an alkaline water spray tower, commonly lime water CaOH2 or NaOH. The alkaline solution reacts with SOx to form precipitates that settle at the bottom of sedimentation tanks or spray towers for further collection and treatment. Typically, the SOx treatment tower is also the water-based dust recovery tower within the boiler's dust recovery system. With that, we have covered the three core issues to ensure boiler emissions meet environmental standards. Let me summarize the three key points. CO gas treatment, carbon monoxide. Dust recovery. NOx gas removal. These are the common issues facing industrial boilers in the Vietnamese market today. I hope this video is helpful to you. Thank you very much.